I think kindness comes from, you know, caring about people and being a good person, and there's a lot of things that I don't feel like I'm fulfilling at the moment. My name's Lucy Bryce. I live in East London in Leytonstone. I'm a mum to two boys, Rufus and Hudson. So I started this children's clothing company. After having two children, I couldn't go back to work. I couldn't afford the childcare. And the motivation was, after having two boys, realising that there was nothing available that I wanted to buy them, so I thought I could do it better myself. It is a real grassroots business. We've done it ourselves, and I think people really relate to the fact that, you know, I'm a young mum. I manage my time not very well, I don't think. I don't want to be one of those mums that's on their laptop all day, and I have to really edit myself. I have to design, I have to sort out, you know, the orders when they come in, so I have to bag those up and post them out. I do the promotion, you know, the marketing, the copy for any press releases that go out. I speak to the stores and do the sales. So, you know, there's a vast array of jobs, so it's that never-ending thing of kind of not feeling like you're doing enough of anything. The only thing I think I look back on and regret after putting all this work into the business is I'm exhausted. So I feel that it kind of rolls over into the energy I have with the kids. My time and the energy that I spend on, I guess, work outbalances everything I put into the rest of my existence. I feel like there's a real imbalance at the moment. I just need to find an even keel. So I don't think I've got the balance right just yet. To me, spirituality means reflecting on your life and thinking about other people. And at the moment, you know, I feel quite self-absorbed that I'm not doing that, and I think that's got quite a negative effect. But it's just like harnessing that now. It's like just kind of controlling, having enough time to make all these possibilities work now is quite hard. I want to have more harmony, just more peace and harmony. And I found it really lonely. I do take quite a lot from people, and I'm super aware of that, and I'm always trying to show people that I'm really appreciative of what they do for me, but I just feel sometimes that I'm so busy, I'm quite flighty, I'm not as gracious as I could be, and that kind of niggles a little bit at me, but I'm aware of it, and I'm trying to, you know, sort that out.
See, the thing about control is that oftentimes control is an illusion. It's like trying to cup a grain of sand in your hands without allowing a single grain to fall out. You know, it's been said that life is 10% of what happens to us, and then 90% of how we react to it. So if you stop and you think about that, really what that means is that we spend 90% of our time reacting and maneuvering to the 10% of things that happen to us that are absolutely outside of our control. Think about it. You can't really control who your parents are, can you? I mean, you can't control who you're related to, what color your hair naturally is. You can't control your height or what's going to happen tomorrow. You can't control the fact that somebody may try to rob you tomorrow. Like, all of these things are outside of our control. But when it comes to our lives, what we do is we try to control the situations, the scenarios, everything about our reality and our future. And sometimes when we stop and we really look at our lives, what we realize is that we aren't actually in control of our lives, but our lives are in control of us. There's a story about a man who was very wealthy. He was actually a royal official, and this royal official had a son who was on the brink of death. And so naturally, as a concerned father would, he used everything that was at his disposal to try to fix his son, to try to make him better, to try to heal him. And he had heard these stories about this man named Jesus who was out in the country doing the miraculous. He was bringing people from death to life. He was bringing restoration and healing to average, normal people. And this royal official, who had tried everything, on a last-ditch effort, comes running to this man Jesus and says, "Please, I've tried it all, and my son still isn't better. I have nothing else left. I am desperate. Will you heal my son?" And Jesus stops, and he looks at the man in the eye, and he says, "Go home. Your son has been healed." And immediately, when Jesus spoke those words, his son was brought from the brink of death to life, and he was healed completely. Are you willing to trust that there's a God who's in control of it all, even when you feel out of control?